Aladdin Creations.
Hello friends, welcome to another video from Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. Today in this video we are going to learn about another gram-positive medically important bacteria called Staphylococcus Aureus. Let's learn about general characteristics, growth and colony morphology, biochemical tests available for diagnosing this bacteria, treatments available and other special features of this Staphylococcus Aureus bacteria.
Staphylococci are gram-positive cocci occurring in clusters. They can be cultured on normal nutrient media both aerobically and anaerobically. In 1880, Dr. Alexander Oxton first showed that a number of human pyogenic pus-forming diseases were associated with a cluster-forming microorganism. He was introduced the name Staphylococcus in Greek language. Staphyl means bunch of grapes. Cocos means grain or berry. Now it uses as the genus name facultatively anaerobic group. They may also can be found as part of the normal flora of other sites such as the upper respiratory tract and are commonly present on animals. The major pathogen within the genus is Aureus causes a wide range of minor and major infections in human and animals. As Aureus causes suppuration, abscess formation, a variety of pyogenic infections and can even cause fatal septicemia. Pyogenic infections are boils, carbuncles, surgical site, wound infection, abscesses, spinal, impetigo mastitis, bloodstream infections, osteomyelitis, pneumonia, ventilator-associated and endocarditis. Toxin-mediated infections are pemphigus neonatorum, toxic shock syndrome, scarred skin syndrome and food poisoning. A number of virulence factors are responsible for the clinical symptoms of infections by this pathogen. Extracellular enzymes and toxins contribute to its invasiveness and pathogenicity. Coagulase, clots plasma, interferes with phagocytosis, facilitates spread in the tissues. Hemolysins, lyses red cells. Leukocinin, kills leukocytes. Fibrinolysin digests fibrin. Lipase breaks down fat. Hyaluronidase facilitates a spread in tissues by destroying hyaluronic acid, component of connective tissue. Protein A, antiphagocytic, prevents complement activation. Enterotoxins, heat stable, cause food poisoning, particularly vomiting. Toxic shock syndrome, toxin 1, shock, rash, desquamation of a skin. Epidermolytic toxins A and B, generalized peeling of the skin. Chemotaxis inhibitory protein inhibits migration and activation of neutrophils. Pus and swabs from infected sites, sputum, cerebrospinal fluid, and blood flow culture are useful for the diagnosis of these organisms. Feces, vomit, and the remains of food when food poisoning is suspected are also used as laboratory specimens. Growth and colony morphology. Staphylococci grow well aerobically and in a carbon dioxide enriched atmosphere. Most strains also grow anaerobically but less well. Temperature range for growth is 10 to 42 Celsius with an optimum of 35 to 37 Celsius. S. aureus produces yellow or cream or occasionally white 1 to 2 mm in diameter colonies after overnight incubation on blood agar. Some strains are beta hemolytic when grown aerobically on blood agar and chocolate heated blood agar. Colonies are slightly raised and easily emulsified. On macconkey agar, S. aureus produces a smaller 0.1 to 0.5 mm colonies after overnight incubation at 35 to 37 Celsius. Most strains are lactose fermenting. Mannitol salt agar is a useful selective medium for recovering S. aureus from fecal specimens when investigating staphylococcal food poisoning. It can also be used to screen for nasal carriers. is Staphylococcus aureus ferments mannitol and is able to grow on agar containing sodium chloride. Mannitol salt agar containing sodium chloride plus 4 mg per liter methicillin is recommended particularly for isolating MRSA strains. The organisms are non-spore-forming, non-motile and usually non-capsulate. The main distinctive diagnostic features of S. aureus are production of an extracellular enzyme, coagulase, which converts plasma fibrinogen to fibrin aided by an activator present in plasma, production of thermostable nucleases that breaks down DNA, and also production of a surface-associated protein known as clumping factor or bound coagulase that reacts with fibrinogen. Biochemical tests for diagnosis of S. aureus. Catalase test. This test differentiates staphylococci which are catalase positive from streptococci which are catalase negative. Note: slide coagulase test is not recommended because of the risk of contamination from active bubbling. Coagulase test. This test is used to differentiate coagulase positive Staphylococcus aureus from coagulase negative Staphylococcus. Coagulase is an enzyme produced by S. aureus that converts fibrinogen in plasma to fibrin. This organism produces two types of coagulases, namely free coagulase and bound coagulase. Deoxyribonuclease DNA test. This test is used to differentiate S. aureus, which produces the enzyme deoxyribonuclease DNAs, from other staphylococci which do not produce this enzyme. It is particularly useful if plasma is not available or when results of the coagulase test are difficult to interpret. Limitations of this test are some MRSA strains do not give positive reactions and some coagulase negative staphylococci give weak reactions. Note: some methicillin-resistant S. aureus MRSA strains give a negative DNA test. Some coagulase-negative staphylococci are weakly positive. Also, aspargines, moraxella, and serratia species frequently give a positive DNA test. Treatment: antimicrobial susceptibility antibiotics with activity against S. aureus include penicillins, vancomycin, macrolides, cephalosporins, fusidic acid. Most strains of S. aureus, particularly hospital strains, are resistant to penicillin due to the production of plasmid-coated beta-lactamase. About 90% or more of S. aureus strains are resistant to penicillin G. Most of these strains produce beta-lactamase. Those organisms can be treated with beta-lactamase-resistant penicillins. Example: nafcillin or cloxacillin, some cephalosporins or vancomycin. Treatment with a combination of a beta-lactamase-sensitive penicillin such as amoxicillin and a beta-lactamase inhibitor such as clavulanic acid is also useful. Approximately 20% of S. aureus strains are methicillin-resistant or nafcillin-resistant by virtue of altered penicillin-binding proteins. These resistant strains of S. aureus are often abbreviated MRSA or NRSA. Such organisms can produce sizable outbreaks of disease, especially in hospitals. The drug choice for these staphylococci is vancomycin, to which gentamicin is sometimes added. Daptomycin is also useful. Trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole or clindamycin can be used to treat non-life-threatening infections caused by these organisms. MRSA strains are resistant to all beta-lactam agents and often to other agents such as amino glycosides and fluoroquinolones. Glycopeptides such as vancomycin or teicoplanin are the agents of choice in the treatment of systemic infection with MRSA, but these agents are relatively expensive and may be toxic. Isolates of MRSA with reduced susceptibility or full resistance to glycopeptide antibiotics are uncommon, but have been detected sporadically. These isolates have either thickened cell walls, important to reduce susceptibility, or the Van A gene, important to fully resistant and can be difficult to detect in the routine diagnostic laboratory. Other important features. There is no vaccine against staphylococci. Cleanliness, frequent hand washing, and aseptic management of lesions, proper sterilization of instruments, good aseptic techniques when handling surgical instruments help to control spread of S. aureus. There are commercially available agglutination tests to identify S. aureus. Several latex agglutination test kits have been developed to identify S. aureus based on the detection of clumping factor and or protein A. Other pathogenic Staphylococcus species. They also called as coagulase negative Staphylococcus CNS, Staphylococcus saprophyticus, saprophyticus causes urinary tract infections in sexually active female. Staphylococcus epidermidis cause usually endocarditis and bacteremia following infection of cannula, indwelling catheters, shunts, or other appliances positioned in the body. Infections are difficult to treat due to the resistance of S. epidermidis to many antimicrobials. Microscopically, S. saprophyticus and S. epidermidis resemble S. aureus.
Well friends, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and gained knowledge about this Staphylococcus aureus bacteria. Don't forget to subscribe this YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.